Hello my friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Haley Hoffman Smith and I like to call myself the friend who helps you bring your pipe dreams to life through manifestation and motivation. I am a subconscious breakthrough coach. It was kind of a profession that chose me. I'm just really fascinated with the power of the subconscious mind and how oftentimes we have blocks that get in the way of us achieving X, Y, or Z or manifesting our full potential because we don't believe that we're worthy of it, we don't think it's safe, or we just don't think it's possible, or a lot of times a combination of all three. Just to go over a quick example of this so you understand what I mean, say that you have a dream to have a New York Times bestseller. So you know that to have a bestseller, that means you gotta sell a lot of books, therefore you need to have a lot of exposure. But maybe deep beneath the surface, you have a fear of being seen. It actually scares you to imagine millions and millions of people knowing who you are, reading your book. There's something attached to a past memory from when you were growing up where you felt judged or you felt ostracized. Maybe it's a learned behavior. You had a parent who was really private, so you feel like it's not safe to be public. So you're wondering, man, why is this not going well? You know, why can't I get more Instagram followers? Why is it not going through to find the literary agent of my dreams? Well, the question we like to ask is, what bad thing happens if you do? And that's how you can figure out if there's a block beneath the surface that is getting in the way. This work has been so fascinating for me because it's really like the puzzle pieces behind our life and the way it stands and how that's dictated by our beliefs and our emotions. And I got really into this work because I've always been into spirituality. Ever since my freshman year of college, I was doing vision boards. I took a meditation and energy work class my senior year of high school. So it's always just been a part of who I was. As I started to pursue my career and my big dreams, I wanted to be a talk show host my entire life. I really wanted to dive into, okay, why are things not showing up the way that I want them to? What's going on behind that? And the biggest part of that journey for me has been this technique, which this video is all about, called emotional freedom technique, otherwise known as tapping, or we call it EFT, just as the cute little acronym for emotional freedom technique. My story with EFT starts my freshman year of college. I actually had really, really crippling anxiety and depression. It specifically came up around test taking. I felt very insecure going into tests. I had a huge perfectionism defense mechanism that came up for me where I just did not feel okay if I had to take a test because I felt like I needed to get 100%. I was really hard on myself and I was really going through a rocky and turbulent mental health time. If you experience anxiety, you know what I mean, where it haunts you all the time. It really changes your life in the worst way. I felt scared to leave my dorm. It was really hard for me to just like go out and get lunch with a friend, and especially that with also trying to do really well in school, but then not feeling good enough to actually take the test. And there were times I'd have to, you know, take medication, or I'd actually have to reschedule the test because it was that much of a panic for me. That plus bouts of depression. All this to say, I was there, I went through that, and I was really a shell of a person. So it was my mom actually who had found an EFT practitioner who could help me. So I went to two of them. They worked with me together. You can really just work with one, but they completely helped me with anxiety. I, to this day, don't really experience anxiety. I mean, I get some butterflies if I'm gonna do a speaking engagement or if I'm excited about something or a little nervous about something, but as far as anxiety, like panic disorder, like what I had been diagnosed with, zero symptoms. I do not have that anymore at all, and the depression, all of that is gone as well. So emotional freedom technique, quick background, because a lot of its studies are rooted in helping people recover from PTSD, anxiety, and depression, and a lot of this around the brain and how the brain reacts, specifically in like panic states or when emotions come up when you think about something or you recall a past memory. Emotional freedom technique is where you tap on certain meridian points and it rebalances the energy centers of your body. At the same time, it also rewires your brain. So I'm gonna just say a disclaimer right now, and that's that I am not a neuroscientist. I can really not describe to you fully how EFT works, so I'm gonna link below a podcast episode that I did with my EFT practitioner, Tiffany Jeffers, who's also a dear friend of mine. She has studied it, she is a practitioner, she's done the training for it, so she explains beautifully how it works. It's still a little bit over my head, but I know enough from years of doing EFT with a number of practitioners and now doing it by myself as just, you know, something whenever anything comes up where I'm feeling an uncomfortable emotion or a limiting belief to be able to tap through it. I'm coming at it from that standpoint where I've gotten the same results over and over again. I help my clients in coaching calls with EFT if we go around a painful memory or if they're feeling anxious or nervous about something. The main gist of EFT see is that it employs those meridian points, like when you think about acupuncture, and I'm gonna go through a full DIY with you so you know how and which points to rebalance the energy center. Here's an example. Say that you have a big presentation coming up at work or at school, and every time you think about it, it's like the blood drains from your face, you feel super panicked, it's really scary for you. Well, in EFT, the whole concept is, where did this come from initially? By the way, you don't really have to find this, but it's best to find the first memory associated. So when's the last time that you went up on stage and it went really wrong? What's the worst thing that can happen? Do you feel like you're gonna be embarrassed? Do you feel like you're gonna open your mouth and nothing's gonna come out? And when did that happen in the past? Because your brain is operating on what's happened previously. So now your brain has this whole neural pathway built out in this example of, if I need to speak in front of people, it is not safe because X, Y, and Z happens. Therefore, we don't want this. This is all about your subconscious mind. Your subconscious mind is operating on literally just trying to keep you alive. And the subconscious mind has not changed since centuries ago, meaning that the same survival impulses that came up for cavemen when they were walking into the forest and they saw a bear actually is the same thing that we experience when we're in traffic and we're stressed out, when we have to give a presentation at work, when a friend says, hey, can I talk to you about something? And you're like, ah, what are we gonna talk about? That same sensation comes up where it really feels like something that's survival based. And so now every time your brain thinks about that friend or that one moment in traffic, or talking in front of people, giving presentations, whatever it is, it has built out this whole neural pathway of the story around that event or that behavior, that person, etc., etc. The crazy thing is, a lot of times we don't know fully why it happens. I tell people all the time, you might have no idea where the sense that you are not smart enough comes from, because maybe it was something that happened when you were in kindergarten and the teacher never called on you and you've never talked about it, you've never really pieced that together. But every single time you think about yourself in an academic setting or in a classroom, you feel a pang of, oh, I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough. And it's all from that first seed that was planted when you were younger and the teacher never called on you, and you remembered feeling ignored. You remember coming to the conclusion that based off the fact the teacher never calls on me, I must not be smart enough. Maybe the teacher doesn't want me to embarrass myself or the teacher themselves. Therefore, I'm gonna keep building out this neural pathway, because what we know is that once you start to believe something, once a situation happens and you construct a view of yourself and your place in the world from that situation, it colors everything that happens after that. So you're always looking for more and more proof. It's actually like confirmation bias. So now that you believe, or you have this inkling of a belief that you're not smart enough, you're now gonna continue to look for evidence of that. We wanna see evidence of what has already been planted into our subconscious. Whatever it is for you, whatever it is that you have come to this video to solve or fix, or if this is your 15th time watching this, there's certain tapping videos. I'm gonna recommend Brad Yates. I'm gonna link his YouTube down below, where I would watch certain ones of his tapping videos over and over again. But what I'm gonna teach you guys is faster EFT and how to do it on yourself at any time you need to. I mean, there's been so many times I've been out in public and something has come up for me and I felt like, oh man, I think I'm gonna cry, or I'm upset or I'm anxious. And I go into the bathroom, I do a few rounds of tapping, I'm completely fine, I feel free. Or if I'm going through something big and emotional, or I wanna do really well on a phone call or meeting, but I know that I'm anxious, I'll do some rounds of tapping, because it's a way of removing that emotional charge so you can do what you need to do and that you can feel free. Here's the thing, emotions, they're important, we need them. Emotions are really what indicates, hey, we've got something we need to check out here, you know, something's not quite right. And we heal and we grow and we transform through emotions, but they don't need to overstay their welcome. You know, I don't think anybody needs to be sad, needs to be anxious, needs to be depressed longer than a certain amount of time. And that's why this tool has really been life-changing for me. And just to know that I can tap on it if I'm having some issue that feels like it's out of my hands has been such a source of relief and comfort for me that I knew I just had to create this video to share it with you guys, so it's something that you can do on your own. So again, this is really like a beginner's do it yourself. I do recommend working with a practitioner if you wanna work on some really big things. So as I said, I worked on panic disorder and depression my freshman year of college. I then went back and actually worked with a practitioner on my fear of flying. I had a huge fear of airplanes. And then I've worked with Tiffany, my EFT practitioner currently, for almost 2 years now, and I now see her every 2 weeks, and we go fully in depth on a lot of the limiting beliefs that are beneath the surface for me that has completely transformed my life. So just as a little picture of what that can look like if you're gonna use EFT for personal development, which you can, and you can use these techniques on yourself for that, in addition to just like removing the emotional charge. I started with her in June 2019. I was living in Colorado. I had quit my job. My business was literally stuck. I was completely stuck in my life. I was so miserable, so unhappy. My face was super swollen. I was perpetually stuffy. It was like I had a cold all the time. I had no energy. I was always procrastinating, no motivation. I was not making anything. I think I was making like $2,000 a month. Given these changes happened over time, but who I am now as I'm recording this video, and it is April 2021, you know, almost a full 2 years later, my life is a complete 180 from that. My business is thriving. I have built a massive following on TikTok and Instagram, working on my fear of being seen. I feel like we're good now, mostly. What I'll say is that what's in your life currently is a reflection of what you believe is safe slash possible for you to have, or what you're worthy of. So a lot of the ways that I was stuck before was really my belief that I needed to be stuck because I was scared of being seen. I was scared of people not liking me, you know, around money. There were some really wonky beliefs around money and my ability to make money and be able to be a business owner on my own. We also were able to work on beliefs around like my big move to New York City. So I moved to New York City, you know, within 6 months of us working together, and my life completely changed really quickly. So while I do believe that this is lifelong work, because we're always going to want to push the envelope and see the full depths and layers of our healing, it really is like an onion, different layers. You keep getting deeper and deeper every single time. I want you to know that even just doing a quick round of tapping, if you're feeling upset with a friend or just feeling a little bit emotional or off, has such a significant ROI, because it doesn't just remove the emotional charge, it actually rewrites the neural pathway. And I'm gonna show you my little trick for doing this that has been super helpful, just as a, let me just do a quick three rounds of tapping and let me change my perspective and my mood for the rest of the day, which in turn changes your life every single time. First of all, I'm gonna walk you through the meridian points. You start with the front of the eyebrow, the side of the eye, underneath the eye, and the collarbone. Those are the four main points around faster EFT. If you have ever done EFT before, you might also recognize the top of the head, underneath the armpit, the little karate chop on the side. Actually, Braddy starts out all of his videos right here where he says, taking full responsibility for your own well-being. And I really like that because this work is about taking full responsibility for your own well-being. You know, you can work with practitioners, work with coaches, work with therapists, but really it's up to you. Like, are you willing to put in the work to feel better and to reverse those limiting beliefs? So I think that's powerful. Go Brad, if you're seeing this, love you. I've actually never met Brad, let me just say this, but just to really illustrate how tapping has worked in my life, a lot through college, because those were really deeply transformational and healing years for me. If I wasn't working with a practitioner, I would watch Brad's videos literally on repeat. You know, sometimes I'd wake up in the middle of the night feeling anxious or sad or something, and I'd look up, you know, tapping for anxiety or tapping for self-worth, and I'd do some videos and it really helped me feel better. Again, going back to the tools piece, just knowing that that was there, that means everything, because I think sometimes, a lot of the time, we're really scared of our emotions. If something's not going well, we really feel like we're at the mercy of the world. And it has really made me shift from like a victim mindset to a victor mindset, to know I don't have to feel this discomfort longer than it's here to teach me something and to heal me. And I can change my life just by reversing a lot of these subconscious beliefs. If you're new, by the way, to everything that I'm saying around subconscious beliefs and limiting beliefs and all of that, I recommend the book, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Joseph D. Murphy, so you understand what I mean when I say your subconscious rules your life experience. This is pretty radical and pretty out there, but I actually do believe it's true to a certain extent, that when you're looking out of your eyes, everything you see is a mirror of your subconscious. So you only see things in your reality if you believe that they're gonna be there. And your experience of reality is consistently reinforcing itself all the time. That's why when people say, if you change your mindset, you change your life, but it's deeper than that. So much easier said than done to be like, I'm gonna wake up tomorrow and I'm gonna be super positive all day. Not necessarily. There's some steps you gotta take on the way there. I think that's an amazing desire and something to have on your to-do list and to work towards and strive towards every single day. But this is where people get burnt out on that self-help motivational work, because they don't find that it's consistent. They don't find that it's something that they can wake up every single day and commit to. And that's because they have rehearsed a different way of being for their entire lives. I'm getting kind of like Joe Dispenza-y here. A book I'll recommend along those lines is Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, or The Placebo Effect, where you have practiced feeling a certain way, it's really hard to change that unless you're gonna do the work on the emotions, on your subconscious, and on those neural pathways around your belief about your experience of life. And do you believe that life is allowed to be easy? Do you believe that you're supposed to be happy all the time? Do you believe that things work out for you? Like, where are those beliefs not fully where they should be, and what would you rather believe instead? I keep going off on side tangents because there's so much to say about EFT, but back to the DIY. So step one is to notice what emotion is coming up for you in your body. So say that you're talking through a really hard situation that's bringing you a lot of sadness. Notice the sad, notice the feeling of the sad. And the thing is to make it as strong as possible. Now, a lot of people don't like going here because they worry, oh my gosh, if I fully feel the sadness, I'm not gonna be able to pull myself out. And I get that, so maybe as you're first getting started, if you're doing this on your own rather than with a practitioner, start with something small and minor, right? So if you are annoyed with a situation at work, if you're sitting in traffic and you're running late and so you're starting to feel a little bit anxious, like do it on those little things at first just so you can feel the difference in your body rather than let me assess my entire childhood trauma based off this one do-it-yourself video. Let me be clear, you can do that. You can go to those full depths always. This tool is amazing for that, but for something that big, I do recommend working with a practitioner who's been trained in this and who can guide you out of it. Anyways, feel the full depths of the sadness, the anger, the annoyance. Try to make it as strong as possible. So what I mean by that is really try to trigger yourself, like really make yourself mad. The more you feel it up front, the more you can dig it out, right? You can only go as deep with yourself as you're willing to go with yourself emotionally. So if it's sadness, allow yourself to cry. That's fine. Like really go there. And once you feel like you have it, the important thing is to keep your chin up so you're not going into a trance. You'll go ahead and you'll start tapping. Now, there's a few ways that you can go about the tapping process. Some, like you'll see if you watch Brad Yates' videos, do this form of I release and let it go, yeah, it's safe to let this go now. You know, kind of like talking through, okay, let me let go of this emotion as you tap through. Sometimes when you work with a practitioner, like Tiffany, for example, she uses NLP, neuro-linguistic programming. So she'll say things to you or have you repeat them based off of what your subconscious has been feeding her or any practitioner. So maybe you said, oh, it feels like I just hit a wall every single time I try to make progress in my business. Well, she's noticed that your subconscious gave that metaphor of hit a wall. And so she'll use that as you're tapping and she'll be like, yep, hit a wall. Okay, smash through the wall. And this is actually talking to your subconscious mind while you're removing the emotional charge. All of that works. What I like to do, which I think is the best thing you can do if you're gonna do this by yourself, if you don't have an NLP background, / if you don't know what to say and you're just like, I release and let it go, I release and let it go, is to imagine animals doing funny things. I say this because I think animals are very disarming. I think they're adorable. And imagining them doing really funny, ridiculous things, I think it might just be my sense of humor, but also when I'm doing my coaching sessions with my amazing clients and I tell them, okay, we got an elephant hopping into a Ferrari to drive up the Amalfi Coast. Imagining an elephant driving a red Ferrari is so funny that it will break you out of the emotion that you felt before. And it also forces your mind to think about something different. So the idea is to feel it as strong as possible and then immediately start tapping and to think about something funny. So something I like to do, here's an example. Okay, say that I am sad, okay? I'm gonna notice the sadness and I'm probably gonna ask myself, what is the sadness on a scale of 1 to 10? So I know what I'm working with. I know what the severity is. So maybe I'm like, oh, the sadness, I'm really sad right now. This is an 8 on a scale of 1 to 10. Okay, notice the 8, notice how you know, and then I'd go ahead and start tapping. And I like to say it out loud, but you can also just like imagine it. So an example of how this could look is right up here. Okay, we got a mouse and he's making pancakes. He's standing over the pan right now. He's flipping pancakes with a giant spatula, side of the eye. And now we're at a diner that's owned by a moose and the moose is putting on an apron. Okay, underneath the eye, now we have a pelican and the pelican is dancing to the Star Spangled Banner collarbone. Okay, now we have an alligator and the alligator is hopping on a motorcycle. He's also wearing a baseball cap. Like throw out the craziest things possible. Then you squeeze your wrist, squeeze it, take a deep breath in and out. Whew. I always make it like a yoga, like whew, a full exhale and say peace. You can also say an affirmation. So like, it is safe to be happy. It is safe to trust life, whatever it is. And then what I find to be really helpful, Tiffany taught me this, is to break the neural pathway by looking up, down, left, and right. I've also added in a little like clap clap, because a lot of times emotion is something that we feel, right? Like, you know you're sad because you feel your heart hurts a little bit, or you know you're anxious because you feel this drop in your stomach or your heart is racing. So changing up what you feel by like clapping, or sometimes if you walk around or if you do jumping jacks, something else Tiffany taught me, like that actually changes the neural pathway so it gets confused. So the concept is feel it as much as possible, force your mind onto something else. People don't like this, by the way. A lot of people feel like, no, I wanna stay in the story. I'm telling you right now, the more that you can force yourself to come up with cute, funny things, animals doing whatever, it's going to move you out of it so quickly, you won't even believe it. I mean, really, people just never believe it. They think it's actual magic, and it is. I mean, the science behind this is phenomenal. This is really how we're gonna change the world. That's why I'm so crazy about this work. After you take a deep breath in, take a deep breath out, you do all that, whatever you wanna switch up, you wanna clap, look up, down, left, right, go to something that is a great memory. Go to something funny. You know, sometimes I'll have a funny TikTok up, and I'm like, okay, I'm using this as like my weapon during EFT to help me, you know, something that's gonna make me laugh. I found that the biggest shifts and changes come from when I fully feel the emotion that I'm trying to get rid of, the sadness, the feeling of stuckness, the anxiety, the anger, and then immediately switch it to laughing. So sometimes I will have like, you know, something that just makes me laugh. I think it's funny. It's a video I saw, something a friend told me, a situation. And I will just immediately, okay, got it. Okay, I'm releasing the letting go. I'm moving my intention. Okay, now I'm gonna think about the funny thing. And I know it's like game over if I start to laugh while I'm tapping. Because I know that by the time I've finished up, I've squeezed my wrist, I've taken a deep breath in, I've gone to a good memory, I close my eyes, I go back on a really good vacation, I imagine something that makes me feel happy and excited. You squeeze your wrist again after that. Another deep breath in. When you go back and check it, so you go back and check the initial emotion, you see if it's changed on that scale of 1 to 10. If I have laughed, if I have thought about something that makes me really happy, sometimes it's really hard to even locate the initial emotion. I mean, this can get cleared out in one round of tapping, which is really amazing. And I'm not just saying, oh, as like a temporary decompressor or whatever, it's healing it within you, it's changing that neural pathway. So the emotion won't come up again unless it's attached to something else. And every single time you tap, it knocks it down little by little. Just imagine the freedom if you kept doing this consistently, because this is my favorite thing in the entire world, I swear. So let's go through another example round. So maybe right now, if there's something that's bugging you, probably just do it with something that's minor until you really get a hang of this. I want you to just think about something that you're like, oh, that's annoying, or that's upsetting to me. And really go there with it. Like, let me know when you got it. That's just like I say in coaching. I'm like, let me know when you got it. You know, close your eyes, go there. I'll give you a second. And once you really feel like you've got it, you go ahead and start tapping. So front of the eyebrow, up here we have a buffalo, and the buffalo is running a marathon. Side of the eye. And now who do we have in the bleachers cheering him on? Okay, we have Bugs Bunny, we have Garth Brooks, and we have Pink Floyd. Okay, underneath the eye, now we have a giant giraffe, and the giraffe is trying on scarves at Saks Fifth Avenue, and he's putting all these scarves up his neck. Okay, collarbone. Now we are at a waffle bar, and in every little divot of the waffle, we have a cute little bumblebee, and the bumblebee is singing Justin Timberlake's Sexy Back. I don't know, come up with whatever you want. I like to give them like a song or something. Okay, squeeze your wrist, take a deep breath in and out. Say peace, go ahead and release your wrist. And I want you to close your eyes and imagine going somewhere in nature. I want you to think about a past memory. So maybe think about the last vacation you went on that was just so good, so fun. Go there, be there, make it really good. Yes, so fun. Maybe you can also add in something funny. Like, what is something recently that made you laugh? Have you ever fallen in front of people and it's been so embarrassing? Have you ever seen someone fall? My dad is gonna hate me for sharing this, but something that gets me honestly every time is when he came to Brown, the college I went to, for parents weekend, and we were walking into the library. It's like this beautiful, quiet fall day. And he completely trips on the stairs in front of the library, is holding his coffee and face plants, but somehow saves the coffee. And just the visual of my dad completely sprawled out on the steps of this like prestigious library holding his coffee. It was so funny. So that will get me, like, so think about something funny like that. And then you'll go ahead, squeeze your wrist again. I almost think this is like the reset button. Okay, we got the good memory in there instead, or the good emotion. Take a deep breath in and out. Release and let it go. Yeah, look up, down, left, right. Something else about looking up, down, left, right is that you can do that if you're in public and you're starting to have a thought that is bringing up a bad emotion. So say that you are going through something and you're trying to stay focused or stay distracted or whatever it is, it's just something that you can't really like emotionally process right now. Well, if the feeling or the thought comes up really quickly, just go like this with your eyes and move them back and forth between the left side and the right side. Look up, down, left, right. I like to notice, you know, if I feel anxiety, I can feel the anxiety, and now I'm gonna like tickle my arm. I'm gonna immediately move it into a different feeling or a different sensation. Okay, go back and check the anxiety. Still there? Okay, now I'm gonna pat my knees. Okay, let me go back and check the anxiety. Still there? I'm gonna squeeze my nose, right? Because it's a feeling in my body, so I want to interrupt the expression of that feeling and that neural pathway by giving myself something else to feel. I also kind of like to do this. Like I really focus on the feeling of my fingers coming against one another because that's a pretty interesting sensation and it makes you focus. So I'll just go like this, release and let it go. Okay, let me think about something funny. Okay, amazing. So that is basically an introduction to do-it-yourself tapping. I encourage you to just do it whenever. I mean, maybe just now that you've learned this, do it throughout the rest of the day. It's those really easy meridian points. I know what I walked you through seemed like an entire experience in itself because there's so many elements. Start with the emotion, the strong emotion, make it as intense as possible, and then immediately move your mind to something else. The funnier, the better, but also you just fall back on animals doing cute things. Force yourself to come up with something creatively, see it in your mind's eye, or have the defenses of like a funny video if there's something funny that you've seen on YouTube that always makes you laugh. Have it up and ready because after you feel the emotion and you go to start tapping, press play, watch it, laugh. You don't even have to have something different for each point. I mean, these points are just really helping you. And then release and let it go. Make yourself laugh again, go back and check it. I promise you'll be amazed how much lighter you feel. I'm here if you have any questions, go ahead and leave a comment below if this was helpful, if you tried this, or if you have any other questions because I'm truly here to help. And as I said, there's gonna be resources linked below. So if you'd like to go further into your tapping journey, know that you have those. I'm rooting for you always, sending so much love. And I also just wanted to add that in addition to the changes that you'll experience in your personal life, just through this technique that I've had, you are going to uplift the entire planet. I mean, this is really the healing and processing work that impacts everybody because we're all so interconnected. So the fact that you watch this video, that you wanna learn, that you wanna improve your own life, thank you on behalf of the planet because we all feel those ripple effects. We're all connected and we all need this. This is really how we change the world. That's why I'm so obsessed with it and I talk about it all the time. Big hugs, my friends. Thanks for watching and subscribe if you haven't already. Bye.